So now the three groups, male, female and transgender, male, female, transgender, right? How many groups are there? How many groups are there? How many category variable? In this case, what is the independent variable? I have the two variables. What is my variable? Gender is my variable. Gender is my variable. So there is, yeah, gender is my variable. Then what is my second one? Gender, another variable is the achievement. Okay, the two variable I'm taking. Which is the independent variable? Anyone can tell?
Gender.
Gender. What is the dependent variable?
Achievement.
Okay, so what is the condition to apply the F test, ANOVA? The category variable at least
more than two groups.
At least
more than two.
More than two.
At least three.
Yeah, that's why I'm put like this. Okay, greater than or equal to three. Okay, in this context only we can use the ANOVA. So can we do ANOVA with SPSS? So see, click the ANOVA and click the this one. Click the data analysis. Kindly check whether which ANOVA is to be more apt. Kindly check. Lot of ANOVA is there. Two factor ANOVA, two factor without replications, with replication and a single factor. Which ANOVA we have to adopt here? Which ANOVA we have to adopt? Single factor. This is called one way ANOVA. This is called one way ANOVA. So after this, I may highlight what is a one way ANOVA, two way ANOVA, what is a factor ANOVA and all. I'm going to do a single factor. What is my single factor in the sense? It's called one way ANOVA. When we can do a one way ANOVA in the sense, we have only one independent variable with three classification. So what is our independent variable? We have only one independent variable, that is called gender. We have three classification in it. The dependent variable should be only one, that is the continuous nature, that is our achievement. This is a main assumption to do a ANOVA. Now I'm clicking the single factor and click OK. How many of them got this dialog box? Kindly check the dialog box. Then what is our input range? Anyone can tell what is our input
range? Male, female and gender.
Therefore I am going to select all. So I am selecting all, even the empty spaces also. See here, you are seeing the B1 to D21. B1 to D21, right? Then can I click the label in first row?
Yes.
Yes,
because I'm selecting that title also, male, female, transgender, as I'm selecting. I'm keeping the alpha value, significant value 0.05. Then output range, I'm clicking the output range. Keep the cursor. People having the confusions. Keep the cursor in the output range and then select the any box, then click OK. Now we are getting the results. How many of them get the results? Got the results, type in the chat box. Yes, thank you. Okay, then see here, male 15, female 20, transgender 10. This for the sum, this for the mean, this for the variance. Okay, now this is our descriptive statistics, but we need a ANOVA table. The ANOVA table, you know, the logic and degrees of freedom between group n minus is nothing but k minus 1. Here, what is the k minus 1? K means number of groups. Okay, number of, we have the three groups, three subcategory, therefore K minus 1, 2. Then within group formula is N minus K. So N, what is our sample? What is our sample size? 10, 20, 35, then 45 for sample size. Therefore 45 minus 3, our K group is 3. Therefore what it happened? 42. So if you're adding this 2 and 42, you are getting the total, what is the ANOVA table, total groups, degrees of freedom. That is called N minus 1. This for the mean square. The logic for the mean square, SSB divided by DAB, like 1958 divided by 2 is equal to MSB. That is called mean square between group. Within SSB, this is called SSW divided by DFW is equal to this much. Okay, just if you are divided, from 11,293.93 divided by 40 for this value. The same value, FRHO, what is the formula for FRH in the sense? Mean square variance of between group divided by mean square variance of within group. It means a 979.322 divided by 264.144. It's called, its answer is 3.70. What is your p-value?
0.032.
What is it? 0.3. Whether it's significant or not significant?
Significant.
Significant. Very good. Significant means whether the null hypothesis is rejected or not rejected.
Rejected.
Exactly. That's the answer. Okay. Now I hope you understand the basic things. Yes. Now, anyone having the doubt in this? Anyone having the doubt to do the ANOVA through the Excel? Can I move to the next level?
Sir, what is the
critical issue?
So what is the significance of that this F value there?
What is the significant? I'm not
aware. How can we use that F value in the interpretation, sir?
So the F value, normally we are writing the previously for 5 years before what the people are doing, we are writing the interpretation based on the table value. So how they compare with it, they are checking the table value with the use of the degrees of freedom in the F table. Then they are comparing with the F value. So the F value greater than the degree, greater than the table value, or F value and less than the table value, they are writing the interpretation. But now it is not needed to look onto the F score. F score can be highlighted in the in the report. No need to be write the interpretation based on the F value. You can write the interpretation based on the P value. Just I'm showing the output. See, this is an ANOVA table output. I'm showing the ANOVA table output. See, this way you have to write. This is called APA. This is called APA 7th version style. F critical value is nothing but F score. Okay, see here. Whenever you are writing the in the dissertation or the thesis, you have to use this structure. F comma bracket 2
sir,
comma
can we get a sample of this?
Yeah, I will share. I will share the Google Classroom.
Thank you.
Please. Yeah, please. See here. In this case, F 2,187. What is the 2,187? Any idea? What is 2,187 represent? 2 is the degrees of freedom within group. 187 is the degrees of freedom within group. Okay. Then is equal to the F value. We can write in the F value. Then after this, comma, P is equal to. In this case, what is the P? 0.00. That's what you are going to write the interpretation like. Hence, there is a significant because the p-value is less than the 0.05. Therefore, what did happen? It is significant. The null hypothesis rejected. Like that, we have to write the interpretation. So this is way we have to write the interpretations. So this is way we have to write the number also because yes, this is same AP style. Yes. Therefore, we don't be much of. You have to write the F value in the table, but while you're keeping the F value in the, you can write it based on the P value. Okay, but don't.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir.
Yes,
sir. If the P value is something like 0.00 and like 000, and then if there is some decimal number, maybe 001, then. Mm-hmm. Mention it when we are interpreting that in our thesis.
Yeah, exactly. Suppose your p value is 0.00. Okay, you can be interpreted this. Yes. This is significant at 0.05 level as well as the 0.01 level. You got
yes, sir. But yes. In the Viva, there was a question asked by one of the professors saying that you are not supposed to mention as 0.00 because somewhere else there will be a decimal.
Yeah, you can specify that is not a total issue. Okay.
Okay. But whatever now, the decision
you mentioned. Each one can is better. All the interpretation you can keep it in only one significant level. Okay. Otherwise, the people make confusing. For one table you are using 0.05, other table you are giving 0.01. It make it confusing. That is why I am telling to the all the even the laymen can also can understand. Some statistician may tell that why you are adding 0.00, why you are not adding 0.000. That is they have the prediction. They won't expect, but when you look on to the layman's view, our dissertation, we are not publishing for the high standing people because our research, it will be reached the normal people also. Therefore, you can write in a normal language, you can go with the zero, but only the things you can keep it stand at the, all the places you can use it here, same interpretation, you can go 0.05 or 0.01. At least you can go with both, right? You don't go below that, okay?
Okay.
So each one's ideas to be different. Okay, for example, I'm not imposing my idea to your research one.
So that no, is no, there was a question asked by
the professor. Because the each examiner have a different mindset.
My question was how to justify that.
Yeah, that's how you can tell. So I'm like, even it may become 0.00, but I'm limited with, you can give us a limitation also. I can keep it my limitation, my research. I'm going to check with the 0.05 only as a limitation. You can give us a limitation. You can come, keep it as a limitation of yourself. Okay? Okay. That's okay, all. Thank you. Okay. Yes, I hope now you are, there is no doubt
sir,
about.
Sir, what is F-crete?
This is called normally when you're taking the sample F score as well as the population treated as a population critical score. Okay, so you can take it this one only you can take it. Okay, if you're taking the consideration of population, it automatically calculates for the population also. That's why it's coming like this. It's tentatively, hypothetically, it's given the answer for the population too. So don't be take this one. Okay, only you can take this F as well as the P. That's enough.
Thank
even
you.
This one won't becomes the SPS, only the Excel it may come in. The SPS won't be there. Yes, I request all to open the ANOVA descriptions. I request all to ANOVA description. Right, once you understand this description, you can easy to understand when you can do a one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, three-way ANOVA, and four-way ANOVA. It's very simple. The parallel you can see what is ANCOVA, what is MANOVA and MANCOVA. Right, can I go with this one-way ANOVA? Yes, what is one-way ANOVA? What is two-way ANOVA? Any idea about one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA? Sometimes we may use the term factorial ANOVA. So don't confuse with factorial, factor analysis and factorial ANOVA. This is called factorial ANOVA. I request all, you can type in your box also, then you can understand the exact difference among the three. Here we may use the term factorial ANOVA, then two-way ANOVA, three-way ANOVA, four-way ANOVA. So I will tell why we can treat it as a factorial ANOVA also. Then I may focusing what is one-way ANOVA. Just few minutes back only we did the one-way ANOVA. What is our independent variable? What is our independent variable?
Gender.
Okay. What is the format? What is the format? What is the type of data? What is the type
categorical.
Of
categorical.
Categorical. Yeah. So categorical. How many variables needed? How many independent
one.
Variables?
One.
One. Only one. Okay. Only one independent. Mm-hmm. How many classification? How many classifications?
Three.
Yeah.
Male, female, transgender.
Greater than or equal to three. Okay.
Greater than two.
Yeah. So I'm making this a greater than equal to three. So this is a basic assumption. Listen, for doing a one-way ANOVA, how many independent? Only one independent. That independent should be a categorical nature. It should be a minimum three classification is needed. Then the case of dependent variable. So what is the type of variable? Any idea?
Continuous.
Exactly, it's continuous. The confounding variable, we are not using the third variable in the case of ANOVA. When you're talking about the ANCOVA only, the COVA means we need a third variable. We need a confounding variable. In this case, no. Right? Just I'm going with the example. I'm going with the example also. See here. What is my IV? What is our IV? I'm taking the gender. I'm keeping as a gender, I'm keeping as a gender itself, okay? Otherwise, types of management. I'm keeping as a type of management. Government, college, aided college, self-finance college. I put as a three classification. Then I'm going to check with the dependent variable. What is our dependent variable? I'm keeping as a emotional intelligence, for example. Emotional intelligence. So in this context, we can use the ANOVA, one-way ANOVA. The main assumption, the independent variable, only one. It should be a categorical, only three classification. The dependent variable should be continuous nature. How many independent? How many dependent? Any idea? How many dependent?
One.
Exactly. Only one. Therefore, it's called one-way ANOVA. Right? Just I'm copying and pasting here as a two-way ANOVA. Right? The two-way ANOVA, number of independent variable may increasing. Only the independent variable is increasing. In the case of two-way ANOVA, how many independent?
Two.
Number two is needed. So here, instead of here three, I put it as a two. So maximum two is enough. For example, gender to religion or gender to locality also. So in this context, there is no thumb rule. Your independent variable, minimum two. Minimum three is not needed. So minimum two or more is needed. Okay. that's enough. The categorical variable 2, dependent variable only one. Whether the confounding variable is there, confounding variable, third variable?
No,
third variable is not there. Just I'm giving the example. I'm going to give with gender. So I'm keeping like a gender also. So what did happen? Type of management with gender. Okay, type of management is a 3 classification. Gender having the 2 classification like male and female. M female, right? You got clear? So what I'm going to do? I'm going to check type of management and gender to the effect of the emotional intelligence as a dependent variable. Okay, I hope you are getting how many independent variable? 2 independent variable. Dependent variable? Dependent
one.
Variable? Only one.
One.
Just say other color. Yeah. So dependent variable only one. Now this is we may treat it as a 3x2 factorial ANOVA. Any idea why I'm telling it's a 3x2 factorial ANOVA?
Because 2 independent variable and means under 2 independent variable, each group 3
No, it's talking about the independent variable only. See this case. What is my first independent variable? What is my first independent variable?
Type of management.
Type of management. How many classification?
3 classification.
3 classification. Gender, how many classification?
2.
Therefore, we may treat this one 3x2.
Yes.
3x2. Factorial ANOVA. You got clear? We may use the term 3x2 factorial ANOVA. These things. Okay. The next thing, how many main effect? So when we talk about this one, we are talking about main effect, interaction effect. How many main effect? What is the main effect? We have 2 independent variable. What is the main effect? Type of management to emotional intelligence, one effect. Then gender to
emotional intelligence.
Therefore, how many main effect? 2 main effect. Then how many interaction? There is an interaction with type of management and gender together, how it will be effect on the emotion intelligence. Therefore, how many interaction?
One.
Therefore, how many hypothesis may testing? How many hypothesis testing? 3 hypothesis. I hope you are getting. So any doubts in this? See here, suppose if you're only doing a 2-way ANOVA, see, I'm going with this also, then you may understand. So I'm keeping here. Okay. In the 1-way ANOVA, we have only 1 main effect. Only 1 main effect. There is no interaction because we have only 1 independent. Therefore, no interaction happened between the independent variable. In the different, totally, how many hypotheses we are checking the 1-way ANOVA?
1.
Hypothesis only 1. Okay. But in the case of the 2-way ANOVA, how many hypotheses we are checking in the sense? The 2 3. Main effects. 2 main effect like type of management to emotional intelligence, gender to emotional intelligence. Then we are blending the 2, type of management and interaction with the gender to the emotional intelligence. Therefore, 1 interaction. Therefore, 2+1, 3. Right. I'm doing the third 3-way ANOVA. Anyone can tell the what is 3-way ANOVA? Please kindly give the answer.
Categorical 3.
So now it's not categorical. So 3 independent variable. How many continuous variable? How many dependent variable?
1.
Only 1. How many confounding?
No confounding.
Then what kind of, for example, I'm taking the other example. So I'm taking the type of management, gender versus locality. So how many is there? How many independent variable? Type of management, gender, and locality. Therefore, 3 independent. How many main effect? How many main effect?
3.
3 main effects. How? What are the main effect? Type of management to emotional intelligence. Gender to emotional intelligence. Then locality to emotional intelligence. Then what are the interactions? What are the interactions?
Type of management with gender with locality, and type of management with
locality. 3 interactions. So please, one is type of management with
gender.
Then another interaction, type of management with
locality.
Then another was type of management
gender with locality.
So there's 3. Then one more is the type of management, gender, and
locality.
Exactly. So how many interactions?
4.
four interactions. Therefore, four. How many hypothesis string?
Seven.
Seven. I hope you are getting. This is called hypothesis string. So I am checking with how many main effect, how many interaction effect, then hypothesis string. Then can you tell what is the factor on ANOVA? This one. What is the factor on ANOVA? Can we tell the number?
3 × 2 × 2.
3 × 2 × 2. Yeah, exactly. So this is called 3 × 2 × 2. This is a factor ANOVA. So just I'm putting 3 × why the 3? I'm using the first. Why am I using the 3 first?
3 types of management. Three groups are there.
Suppose type of management only 2 classification. Then what it happen?
2 × 2 × 2.
It got clear. Based on the number of category of the first independent variable, it may be changed. I hope now you are getting. Please kindly suggest anyone the fourth one only. Then after I move to the next one. That is a four-way ANOVA. This is a basic.
Independent variable 4 and dependent variable 1. No confounding variable.
Yeah, exactly. So thank you. Then you can check the number of independent main effect. How many main effect?
Four.
Yeah, then you can tell the possibilities. For example, I'm using the another variable like locality versus religion. Okay, so what are the comparison? Type of management with the?
With the gender.
Then type of management with the locality.
Locality.
Type of management with the?
Religion.
Then type of management with the?
Gender.
Genders. Then what is the next one?
So, next one is gender with locality.
Yeah, so first, last one, what is it? Locality. Then what is the last one I'm typing? Locality with
religion.
Religion. So gender, locality,
religion.
Everything's okay, no? So yes. Now next one is the gender with the
locality.
And gender with the
religion.
Gender with
religion.
Then next one.
Then locality with religion.
Locality with religion. Then so now we are comparing it to 2 classification. Then you can go with the 3 classification. So type of management with gender with
locality.
Locality. Then type of management with gender.
Gender and religion.
Religion. Then type of management with
locality and religion.
Locality and religion. The next type of management with it's over.
Gender, locality.
Yeah, it's over. Then gender with locality, then religion. So like that you can go with it. 15 hypothesis may testing. Kindly check. It may checking the 15 hypothesis. Kindly check your end. I think it's 15 is checking. Okay, kindly check one by one and how many interaction effect. Up to 4 you can go and check it how many numbers. Then one way ANCOVA, I'm moving to the ANCOVA. Please, anyone can idea about ANCOVA? Kindly give the answer. The same one way ANCOVA, the assumptions are same only.
Independent variable 1 will be there.
Dependent variable 1 as a continuous register, only the thing. Confounding variable, how many?
One.
Any idea?
One.
Any idea? It's only one. Or minimum one.
Minimum one.
Okay. So minimum one is needed. Okay. But what's the format? Minimum one variable is needed. Minimum one variable. What is the format? What is the type? Is it a continuous or categorical?
Continuous.
It's a continuous. Please kindly, dear scholars, this is the main because most of the people are without knowing they are doing the ANCOVA and all. So the main assumptions to doing a ANCOVA. We need a minimum 3 variable for one way ANOVA. The independent variable should be a categorical nature. Dependent variable is a continuous nature. Confounding variable should be a continuous nature. But confounding variable, it may one or more. If you are using 2 also, no problem. Yes, now see here. I am keeping the another example, TV, as well as the, I am using the confounding variable, CV. CV is a confounding variable. Right? Just I am keeping different color, then you can easy to understand. Yes. So in this case, independent variable type of management, dependent variable, emotion intelligence, then CV, I'm taking is the intelligence. right? Because intelligence may be influenced by emotional intelligence, therefore called confounding variable. Otherwise, you can go with the emotional maturity, then social, like that you can use any one, okay, as a confounding variable. So here we are going to control the intelligent effect into the independent variable to dependent variable. This is called ANCOVA, one-way ANCOVA. Anyone can tell the two-way ANCOVA? Two-way ANCOVA?
Independent two.
Okay, that it should be two only. So it's not compulsory, it's a three. Then continuous one, dependent variable one, confounding variable, it should be a continuous, right? Please, this is an assumption. Anyone having the doubt, you can ask. ANCOVA, you can use the extension of ANOVA only is ANCOVA, but in the context of the one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, it differ based on the independent variable. If you're using only one independent variable, that's called one way. If you're using two independent variables, that's called two way. If you're using three independent variables, that's called three way. So like that, if you go with five independent variable, you may treat it as a five-way ANOVA. The same way ANCOVA also, it may be varying with the number of independent variables. If you're using a single independent variable, that is called one way. If you're using two independent variables, that is called two way. If you're using three independent variables, that's called two way, three way. Now the same thing, see this case, I'm using the confounding variable. So here I'm using the type of management with the gender. With the gender, so therefore two independent variable, one dependent variable category continuous, confounding variable also continuous. You can go with the two also, no problem. Then anyone can tell three-way ANOVA? Anyone can tell three-way ANOVA? Independent three, exactly. Other things are same, right? Now I move to the ANOVA. After that, I'm doing for the directly going for the demonstration. Come to the ANOVA, please. What is a ANOVA? Any idea? What is it represent a ANOVA?
More than one independent variable.
What is the expansion of ANOVA?
So dependent variable that
multivariated to cover
multivariate analysis of variables.
I'm talking about the expansion only, multivariate, exactly. Okay, the people are giving the answer correct. Okay, the difference between the ANOVA and ManoVA, anyone can briefly highlight what is the exact difference between the ManoVA and ANOVA? Anyone?
Dependent variable is more than one.
Exactly. Please listen. In this variable, is the dependent variable is less than or it's a greater than or equal to two. Minimum two is needed. Minimum two is needed in the context of the ManoVA. If the dependent variables increase, it is called Jijo, independent variable is more. In this case, ANOVA and ManoVA is differ based on the number of dependent variable. One way, two way, three ways depends on the independent variable. I hope you are getting. ManoVA and ANOVA differ based on the dependent variable. If you are using the only one dependent variable, we may use the term ANOVA. Everywhere you may use the term ANOVA. But if you are using more than two or more dependent variable, we may keep it, that is called ManoVA. Multivariate analysis. This is a main assumption, right? In this case of ManoVA, if I take is only one independent, then it's called, if I take only one independent, what it called?
One-way ManoVA.
Only one independent.
One-way ManoVA.
Only one independent, that's called?
One-way ManoVA.
Right. If I go with two-way ManoVA, what is that assumption, please? Anyone tell? Two-way ManoVA? Two-way ManoVA?
Two independent variables.
So in the case of the two-way, three-way, four-way, the ways differ based on the number of independent variables. But the ManoVA and ANOVA differ based on the dependent variable. I hope you are getting any doubts. The ManoVA and ANOVA is differ based on the this one, dependent variable, the way is to be differ based on the independent variable. I hope now you are clear. Can I move to the next level? Yes. So the final one, yes. What is Mankova? What is called Mankova? Any idea? What is called one way Mankova? Others kindly mute. Pradishka, kindly unmute and talk to me. Others.
Multivariate covariance.
Then what is that data is needed? What are the data is needed?
Confounder.
We need at least
one confounding variable.
What is the format we need? What is the type?
Continuous.
What is the type?
Continuous.
Exactly. So right. So if you have any doubt, yeah, thank you. Can correct that. All are correct. Just I'm going to ask some questions to you. Kindly, I'm going to close the screen. Then I'm going to ask the questions. So the questions to anyone, kindly type in the answer in the chat box. Two-way ANOVA. I'm talking about the two-way ANOVA. Suppose the first independent variable, four subgroups. The second independent variable, only two subgroups. What kind of factor ANOVA? The first thing, four classification. The second one is two classification. What kind of factor ANOVA? Yeah, exactly. That is called 4x2 factor ANOVA. Suppose the first category is two classification. The second category, second independent variable is four classification. What is that? Kangana is correct. Two class four. Suppose I'm using three independent variable. If I'm using three independent variable, only one dependent, what it means? I'm talking about the, you can tell the ANOVA types. I'm not talking about the factorial. What is the ANOVA? It's one way ANOVA, two way ANOVA. I'm using three independent, only one dependent. What it means? Three way ANOVA. Exactly. Suppose, please listen. I'm using three independent, one dependent, and one confounding variable. What it means? Yeah, three way ANOVA. Exactly. I'm so happy. Then suppose I'm using. Only one independent, one independent, two dependent, one confounding. What it means? Please kindly see. I'm using one independent, two dependent, one confounding. What it means? Yeah, that is called one way ANOVA, right? I hope now you have the crystal clear about the ANOVA and ANCOVA. Can I move to the demonstration? I'm sorry, I'm taking much time for explaining this one. Can I move for my present? Yes. One of the things, whenever you are hearing the terms co-represent covariance, it means we need a third variable is needed. I'm skipping this.
Sir, share this Excel file with us because we couldn't type and learn both together.
Oh, yeah, I will share this. I'm sharing the Excel file finally. Okay. Yes, see the case, this is a table. I hope you are familiar with this. If I explain, it takes much time. I will share this PPT. Only the things, why we had to do the ANOVA, just I'm showing with the diagram representations. There's a three groups like male, female, and transgender. There's a two groups. The three groups are satisfying the normality. See here, you are seeing the normality property satisfying. The mean group of the first group here, the second group mean score, the third group mean slice here. Normally we are writing the interpretation of F based on the between group variance as a within group variance, because F ratio we are finding find like this, between group variance divided by within group variance, right? See this case, how the variability happened, whether it will be significant or non-significant, how we can be justified in the sense based on the distance. See this case, just I'm taking the one pen, then I can easily to understand. I'm seeing the pen. See this case. This is called between group. So the three groups, the between group variance this much distance. But within group variance, this is one group within group. Within the group variance, this is second group within group variance. This is the third group within variance. If you're adding the three groups variance also, it won't be equal to this one. So which group variance so high, whether the between group variance is high or within group variance are high, kindly see in this example which is the group variance are high, whether it's a between group or within group. Within group variance.
Between.
Therefore, what is the formula for F test? F is equal to mean square variance of between group. I am typing only B divided by within group. For example, I am typing 2/1. So for example, the difference is just an example. The between group is 2 cm. And example I am quoted. Within group only 1 cm is comes. Therefore, what is the answer? 2.
2.
Right? Suppose the between group is less. Suppose the between group is 1. Within group distance is high, 1/2. Therefore, what did happen?
0.5.
Therefore, which ratio is high? Whether which ratio is high? The first ratio is high.
The first ratio is high.
Quite high in the sense, because if the between group variance are high, if compared to the within group, automatically the F ratio should be high. If the F ratio is high, what did happen? The significant arise. It got clear? You got clear? The significant arise. Okay, see this example. I'm going with the next example. See this case. Here, which is the between group variance? This is a between group variance, right? What is the within group? This one within group, another within group, another within group. Therefore, distance, see here, the distance of the within, it starts from here to this much. Therefore, which variance are high? Whether the between group variance are high and between group variance are high?
Within group variance are high,
it won't be affect much, right? Therefore, the interpretation, the F ratio won't be high. It's not significant errors. Now we got clear why the significant errors are not significant errors in the case of the three groups. You got clear?
Yes.
So based on this diagram, you can easily to understand why the significant errors. So this is a formula. Just I'm going with the pathway and directly go with the demonstration. Because this PowerPoint I'm sharing, the pathway and the other interpretation, everything is there. Because due to the time fact, I'm not able to show this PPT, entire PPT. Even the postdoc only I'm telling. So this is important. When you're doing the postdoc test, the people, when you're seeing the postdoc test in the SPSS, you are getting a lot of postdoc. Even the variance, homogeneous variance, equal, homogeneous non-equivalent also, you may get a lot of postdoc. But better you can go with the Dakey test. Because the Dakey test may easy for to compare the all the groups comparisons. But in the case of Safai test, we are checking only the unequal, but the bone foreign area is more powerful, but the problem with, we can check only the sum pairs only. Therefore, most of the researcher, now they are using only the Dakey, so you can use the Dakey. This is an assumptions, I already talked with the assumptions to you. Dependent variable should be measured in interval ratio. Independent variable, three are more categorical. It's a categorical nature. The independent variable, independence of observation, like gender, male, female, transgender. The transgender students won't be come to the male group, or female students won't be come to the transgender group. So it means that each variable, each independent variables to be independent to each other. There is no significant outliers. All the dependent variables should be satisfied with the normal distribution. Then the homogeneity also with may satisfy with the Levenge test. I may focus it to you. I am going to the SPSS. I request you all to open your SPSS. So I hope how you can open the SPSS. Open this IBM SPSS. There you can open the SPSS. Okay, you can open the SPSS. Kind of open the SPSS. I request you all to open. You can do parallelly, because I am going to do first was one way ANOVA, then two way ANOVA, then I am going with one way ANCOVA, two way ANCOVA. If you need, I can talk about ANOVA, otherwise I'm skipping this ANOVA and other things. Then one more thing, repeated measures ANOVA also there. So if it time possible, I may focusing the repeated measures ANOVA. It is an extension of the probe sample t-test. Because when you're talking about the one way ANOVA, two way ANOVA, three way ANOVA, it's an extension of the independent sample t-test. But in the case of the probe sample t-test, we need some kind of extension in the ANOVA also. That is called repeated measures ANOVA. That we have to go with the different assumptions. I hope you are seeing my SPSS file. Before opening the SPSS file, kindly close the Excel file with you. You have the Excel file, no? Kindly close this Excel file, because it, otherwise it won't be work in your SPSS. Just to close this Excel file. Kindly close this Excel file. Yes. Yes. So kindly ensure whether you close. Now I'm going to open the Excel data. I'm going to, yeah, what is that? Import the Excel data into the SPSS. What is the path? Anyone can tell the path? What is the path to add this data
file
here?
Open data.
Open data. So please kindly ensure where you are keeping your data. Yes. So I'm keeping the desktop. Then I'm not able to see the Excel. What we have to do, we can change the file type in the Excel. Very good. So in the Excel, I'm keeping this Excel data sheets morning. Open it. I'm keeping the lot of survey, experimental and descriptive statistics like this. Better you can go with the survey now. Only the survey, the first sheet which I'm given to you, click survey and click OK. So kindly see how many of them seeing the survey. Yes. So how many of them seeing this one? Yes. So kindly define, then you see to you. You can go to the variable view. Kindly define the gender, one male, kindly define, then you are getting some good output of looking. That's why I'm doing. Two is a female, kindly define like this. Female, then going with a qualification, one is UG, then two is PG. Kindly define. Then it's not compulsory, but for looking the output, you may easy to see. Okay, locality, one is rural, two is urban. Then management, I'm going with one is a government, two aided, three self-finance. So can I take half an hour extra? Can I finish up to 1 o'clock? Can I go with up to 1 o'clock?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So click OK. Then college type, you can go with, I think, college type, how many classification I will check. College type also three is there. So just I'm going to boys college, girls college, and co-ed. Okay. So one is boys college. Then two is a girls college. Then third one is co-ed. Right. So you can go with that. Then okay. So I'm defining residence and all. Yes. Now you are seeing this. You come to the data view. How we can check the variable which is changed there? No. How we can, whether it's visible in this end? Here we can see only the numbers. How we can see what are the modification we did in the variable? Is it possible to see here? What is the option?
Yes, sir. A1.
Yeah, exactly. Click the A1. You can check. Click the A1. You can check whether the modification from your end, what are things you did, whether it should be there or not. Yes. Now, the questions to all of you. There's a three variable I'm using: study habits, achievement, intelligence, right? For doing ANOVA, I may treat each variable as a dependent. Study habits, one dependent, achievement is a dependent, intelligence is a dependent, right? You got clear? Because dependent variable, it should be continuous. Therefore, we can treat study habits, achievement, and intelligence as a, dependent variable. Suppose when I'm going for ANCOVA, which variable can treat it as a covariate? Anyone can tell which variable we can treat it as a covariate?
Intelligence and achievement.
Yeah, so you can treat it as intelligent as a, you can keep it as intelligent as a covariate, okay? Because the study habits is independent. If you're taking the correlation, if you go for the correlation, both the variable, independent variable, dependent variable should be in a continuous nature. Therefore, the study habits is also independent variable, achievements dependent variable in the case of correlation. But in the case of the ANOVA, independent variable is maybe a management, dependent variables is study habits, or independent variable management or achievement. You can change as you like. Based on the objectives, you can keep it, which is independent dependent. Can I go for the demonstration? Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
First, we can go with one-way ANOVA. One way whenever we are doing the comparison only, we are doing the comparisons of the mean groups only. So I'm going to compare, what is my assumption, what is my hypothesis? I'm going to check whether the management having the effect on the steady habits or the management having the effect on the achievement. Therefore, what is my hypothesis? Anyone can tell the hypothesis, null hypothesis? There is no significant difference.
Among added college, self-finance college and government
college. On in the
study habits.
Right. That's okay. Now I'm doing the data. Go with analyze. Because we are going to compare the means only. Compare means, then one way ANOVA. Kindly see the path. Analyze. Compare means one way ANOVA. This for only for one way ANOVA. Now see this case. What is the dependent variable?
Steady habits.
Steady habits. Okay, I am keeping the steady habits. Then what is my independent variable?
Management.
Management, because on the management only the three classifications, therefore I am keeping the management. So here, instead of independent variable, they are using the word as a factor. What are the factors influencing? Management as a factor. The management having three factors, government, aided and self-finance. Therefore, we can keep it the factor as an independent variable. Up to this, any doubt? No doubt at all. Okay. Now, the contrast is not needed. Don't click the contrast. Click the post-hoc. Once you click the post-hoc, see here the equal variance assumed in the case of the homogeneity. Then equal variance not assumed. Kindly check. You can assume that it's equal variance assumed only. Kindly check the Dakey. Kindly click the Dakey test. Kindly click the Dakey. Once you click the Dakey, then significant level is nothing but alpha. Level of significance 0.05. Click continue. First, you can fix the post-hoc. I hope no doubt at all the post-hoc. Only I'm clicking this Dakey only. Suppose if you want to click the other also, you can do it. I can go with Safi and Bone for it. But better, you can go with a single one. Dakey is enough. But for your purpose, I'm showing the three output also. I'm clicking continue. Then the next one, click the options. I need a descriptive also. Therefore, I'm clicking the descriptive statistics. Then we have to check, because one of the assumptions, we have to check whether the homogeneity is satisfying or not. Homogeneity variant, therefore I'm selecting the homogeneity variance. Yesterday we did the homogeneity variant with the t-test. The t-test you did know. The same thing, the Levenger test outputs only may come here. For that I'm going the homogeneity. Then mean plot, therefore the diagram representation I'm doing the mean plot. Then continue. Only this much is enough. Post hoc, you can select the key. In the options, you can select the descriptive, homogeneity and mean plot. Then click OK. How many of them got the results? How many of them got the results? The same results you are getting? Good. So thank you, Kangana. Any others, please? Those who are getting the report, kindly type in the chat box. Yes. Good. Right. Thank you all. Now you have to tell. What is the first table?
Descriptive statistics.
So that is for purpose we are doing. That is N mean standard deviation standard error. Other things not needed. Now, what is the second table?
Homogeneity of variances.
Homogeneity of variance. According to the ANOVA test, it may be satisfying the homogeneity. Now, satisfying the homogeneity, what is your hypothesis for the homogeneity test? So I'm going to treat it that there is no significant difference in the homogeneity. It clicks that all the groups are same. The variance wise, all the groups are same. Is a null hypothesis I'm keeping. What is the significant value? See the significant value. Yesterday, the professor was asking the question. Now you can easily to understand whether it's significant or not significant. Kindly see what is the significant level? 0.05. So what is our p-value? 0.09. If you compare with 0.05, what did happen? Is significant or not significant?
Not significant.
Exactly. Not significant represent what? Not significant. Both the groups are? Both the groups variance are?
Null hypothesis.
Both the groups variance?
Null hypothesis not rejected.
Exactly.
There is a homogeneity of variance.
That is important. So instead of null hypothesis accept or rejected, you can link things. Not significant means what? Both the groups variance are same. Therefore, our assumptions are satisfied. The equal variance are satisfied. Then you can come down. You got clear? So now you can check the Levenger test. If the Levenger test is not satisfying, you don't be look onto the ANOVA, because you cannot be do the ANOVA. here is not satisfying the sense. You got clear? Yes, right? Sir. Now it's satisfying. Therefore, we can see the lower column, ANOVA. What is our ANOVA F value? 24.857. What is our P value? What is the P value?
0.0.
So kindly tell whether it's significant or not significant.
Significant.
Significant at what level?
0.01 level actually. So 0.01.
Okay. So it both the levels to be significant. Once it's significant, we can go with the, you can see the postdoc. Once it's not significant, don't need to look onto the postdoc. You got clear? If it's significant only, what is the need? What we have to look on it? Postdoc. If it's not significant, what is not needed? Postdoc is not needed. Why in the sense, if it's significant in the sense, we have to check whether which group is good, which comparisons having the significant relations. Significant.
The difference is existing. Which group?
Each group. Oh, yeah. Okay. So suppose here it comes not significant. Here it comes not with significant. Then what is the need to be see the postdoc? No need to see the postdoc. You got clear? There is a queries from the Vandana. Vandana, kindly see. You are asking about the one saying Levenger test. Levenger test is checking whether the both the groups variants are same or not. What is the null hypothesis? We are keeping that both the groups variants are same. That is our null hypothesis, right? What is the p value is coming? What is the p value? 0.09. Is compared to 0.05. It is not significant. Not significant represent both the groups are same in the variance. It seems that homogeneity property is satisfying. So the basic assumptions of doing a ANOVA, see the, I'm opening the assumptions. See the assumptions. So the assumption number 6. What is that assumption number 6? Homogeneity of variance. Therefore, the variance of the each group it not be different to each one. So here it's satisfying the assumption. Therefore, we can go with one-way ANOVA. Suppose it's not satisfied, if you're doing the ANOVA also, it's not be fair because it's not satisfying the homogeneity test. Then what is the need to see this go with ANOVA table? Right? So now if you're now you have doubt, Vandana? Do you have any doubts? I hope you now you're clear. So now in the ANOVA table, you are checking the significant. Therefore, you can see the postdoc. In the postdoc, I need only the Daki, but the Safi test bone for any result, same result only. See these results of the Daki test, Safi test, and bone for any. The results are same only. Therefore, you can go with the single one. So, sir, if the variance is not homogeneous, you don't go for a ANOVA. It not, what is the ANOVA? It's not meaning. There is no need to go for it ANOVA then. Because the main assumption to do ANOVA, some of the properties, independent variable categorical nature, dependent variables are continuous, it may satisfy the normality, no outliers, the another one is called homogeneity property. If it not satisfied any of the assumption, you don't go for, what is this, ANOVA. You got clear, you can go with non-parametric then. Right, then see here, the government, there's a comparison, government aided, government self-finance, you can see the significant. Government aided. What did happen? Government aided. Anyone?
Significant.
Government self-finance?
Not significant.
Right. Aided government is already there. Aided government significant. Therefore, aided government self-finance?
Yes, significant, sir.
Significant. Therefore, in which are the groups significant arise? Kindly tell once again. Which are the group has the significant arise?
Between government aided, aided and self-finance.
Comparison of two, government aided one comparison, yes, coming then
one. Aided, the other aided, one is government
aided and self-finance, that's you have to mention. Now how we can write the interpretation for this, just to see this table, I'm showing the interpretation table. See this, once the significant arise, see this another score, so don't confuse with this is another score, the significant arise. Therefore, what we have to do, we can add this comparison table. Here I'm going with the comparison, this one here they I'm making a bold mark. You have to write the interpretation like this. This will actually towards the Google Apps and the research. So here we can write like this. The Daki test revealed that attitude towards the Google Apps for education was statistically significant lower of below 35 age group. You have to write like this. This for the mean score, this for the standard deviation, this for the APA format. is for the APA format. We have to write interpretation like this only. The mean value, then significant, that is standard deviation value, then p value. What is the p value? The below 35 and the above 55, this one. Then similarly, 35 to 50 groups, that mean value and standard deviation, then p value. Then finally, we can give the significant where it arises, in which are the groups this arises. We have to justify it in the interpretation. Okay, this way we have to write the interpretations. If you come down, you are seeing the mean plot. The mean plot also we can see. The mean plot, it means, see here, this is an aided college. The aided college mean is nearly 197, something is there, because you can see the point. This for the self-finance is nearly 205. This is for the 210. This is for the aided. Therefore, what it happens, see this case, government and self-finance, not that much of interest. Government and self-finance. Because government and self-finance look like a say. If you're adding some lines, somewhat very near. But in this case, government and aided, lot of mean difference. So that's why the significant arise. As well as the self-finance and aided. Self-finance and aided, that also lot of difference. Therefore, from the diagram itself, we can easily find out where the significant difference arises, in which groups having the significant difference arises comes. Okay, so can I move to the two-way ANOVA? Do you have any doubt in this one-way ANOVA? Can I move to the two-way ANOVA?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, okay, thank you. So now I'm going to the two-way ANOVA. I click the ANOVA, but previously we are going with one-way ANOVA, therefore we are going to compare means. But here only one-way ANOVA is permissible. For doing a two-way ANOVA or ANCOVA, we can go with general linear model. Please kindly see what is I'm using. General linear model. There's a two options. See here, univariate and multivariate. Any idea? Univariate and multivariate. Whenever you are doing the ANOVA, ANCOVA, you can depends on the univariate. Whenever you're doing ANOVA and ANCOVA, you can go with multivariate. Whenever you're doing a repeated measures ANOVA, you can go with the repeated measures. There's a three options they given. Univariate for the ANOVA or ANCOVA, multivariate for ANOVA and ANCOVA, repeated measures ANOVA. Now kindly click the univariate, see the spaces, see dependent variable fixed factor. The same view it comes to the multivariate also. I request the participant, this is caller, kindly check the difference between the univariate dialog box as well as the multivariate dialog box. This is a univariate dialog box. I am opening the multivariate also. See here, I am opening multivariate. Both the options are same only. Whether did you found any unique difference between the two dialog box? Please, one thing I'll do, I can open the multivariate. You can open your laptop univariate. Kindly check the difference between the your dialog box and my dialog box of the multivariate and univariate. Anyone can give the answer? Why is called univariate?
Random factor is there.
Random factor is not in much inflict. I'm already mentioned that the multivariate, the ANOVA and the ANOVA is differ based on the number of
dependent
on dependent variable. Kindly see this page, kindly see the column of dependent variables in both univariate and multivariate. Kindly see and then give that answer.
Only
kindly
one see. Dependent variable is there in univariate.
Univariate.
Multivariate. See the multivariate space. See the multivariate space.
It's wider.
It has a lot of space.
Wide. Yeah. It's wide. See this case of univariate.
It's narrow.
Only one. You could not be at. For example, I'm adding the study habits. See here, I'm adding the study habits. I'm trying to add the achievement. See here. It's not possible. Okay. But see here, I'm going with analyze. I'm going with multivariate. I'm going with study habits. I'm like to go with achievement also. I'm going to try to intelligence. See this case. What did happen?
More than one variable. That
more
is
than one variable. Therefore, it is called ANOVA. You got clear?
So the admitting itself says, sir, dependent variables and in univariate dependent variable. Singular.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Right. Here you are referring the dependent variables, plural. Yes. But yes. In the case of the general linear model univariate, you are getting general dependent variable. You got clear? But the fixed factor, see the numbers, fixed factor bracket, yes. Therefore, it may be a multi. Okay. So can we do now? So one, what do you have to, what is the path? Analyze general linear model. Then which one I can go? Please kindly tell me.
Univariate.
Yeah, Anava. Yeah. What is the hypothesis? What is the hypothesis? See, I'm going to, you are going to frame the hypothesis. I'm going to compare like this: gender and management. Okay. Gender management on study habits. So what is my independent variable? What is my independent variable?
Gender and management.
Gender and management.
Gender and management. What is my study? What is my dependent variable?
Study habits.
So how many hypotheses?
Three.
So the first hypothesis, see here, there is no significant difference in the mean scores of what is the study habits with respect to gender, right? The second one, there is no significant difference in the mean scores of study habits with respect to management.
What is the third one?
There is no significant difference in the mean scores of study habits.
Gender and management.
With respect to the interaction of
interaction.
Gender and management.
So if you want to make it a single hypothesis, what you have to do? There is no significant difference in the main effect and the interaction effect of gender and management in the
study habits.
You can make it, instead of three hypotheses, you can make it a single hypothesis. How we can make the hypothesis? So there is no, just I'm sharing the two-way and our hypothesis. See the hypothesis. Yeah. So I'm not making the hypothesis. So what is the hypothesis we have to make in this sense? There is no significant difference in the main effect and the interaction effect of type of management and gender on to the study habits, right? You got clear? This way we have to write the hypothesis. I'm going to do a calculation now.
Yes, sir.
Analyze general union model, univariate. Now we have to tell, what is my dependent variable?
Study habit.
What is my, actually we are fixing the factor. We already know what is the, because we have framed the hypothesis. From the hypothesis, we can know what is the independent variable. What is my independent variable based on my hypothesis?
Gender and management.
Where we can give, whether we can give the fixed factor or random factors, we are already fixed what is our independent variable. Therefore, where we can keep it?
The fixed factors.
Fixed factors, exactly. Then, what is the second variable?
Management.
Yes. Now we can tell what is the factor analysis. What is the factorial analysis? Is it a 2 cross 3 or a 3 cross 2?
3 cross 2.
Gender 2.
Yeah, what is the first independent variable? What is the first independent variable?
Gender.
What is my second?
Management.
Therefore, it means 2 into
2 cross
3.
Suppose
I am putting management first. What did happen?
So 3 cross 2.
It got clear. So I'm now, yes, it's a 3 cross 2, right? Then after this, nothing's to be needed. If you're adding any covariate, it's called ANCOVA, right? I'm not doing any ANCOVA. Now I'm going to go with the plot. These two things not needed. Don't change the model as the contrast. Go directly to the plots. I'm going to check whether the interaction happened based on the diagram also. We have to check the diagram also, whether the interaction is coming or not. For this, I'm using the plot option. Kindly see the plot options. Once you click the plot options, first, you have to keep the first variable, management, is horizontal axis. Gender is a separate line. So the first pair is checking with horizontal axis management, and y-axis is a separate line, is the gender. Add. So the first graph comes like this. I like to go with horizontal axis as a gender, y-axis as a management. So the second pair, second diagram, I'm clicking. Therefore, you can go with the two diagram. One is checking the x-axis as a management. Other one is checking the x-axis gender. So we may get two diagrams, okay? Then click continue. So do you have any doubts for checking whether the interaction happened between the two variables, with the two independent variable, I'm checking like this. So will it make the difference? No, nothing. There is no doubt. There is no influence on the, if you change the position of the independent variable. Nothing. The same answer only may comes. The same answer. Yeah, now go with the post hoc. So kindly see which variable may act for post hoc test, which variable may act for the post hoc test. Can we go with gender? Is it possible?
Yes.
Possible?
Yes, no.
How? Gender, how many
classes? No,
management. Only two groups.
Then what is the need for post hoc? Suppose I'm putting gender
management, here. Management.
That is a problem management. With the people. If I put gender, output may comes. I'm putting both. I'm putting the gender and management. We'll see the final result. But which is more acceptable here? Only the management only we need here. Post-web, but I'm keeping gender also. The results may come. That's why don't keep like this. Then equal variance assumed. I'm going with the Ducky. I'm going to Ducky. Then continue. So what are the things I did? In the plot, I'm kicking the graph. The post-work, I'm kicking the Ducky only. Then I'm going with the options. The options. I need the mean scores of all. I'd like to get the mean scores. Therefore, I'm selecting all the management, gender, and interaction effect also. Two main effect and interaction effect mean score I need. I need the descriptive statistics. I need a effect size. That is called effect size is better, you can find. Then homogeneity. We have to check the homogeneity also. Homogeneity and click. And the significant level 0.05. 0.05. Then continue. Then click OK. Only this much is enough. Kindly see the results. How many of them got the results? How many of them got the results? Kindly type in the chat box. Those are getting the results. Those are getting the results. Kindly type in the chat box. Yes, Nithya is getting. Yes, Priyanka. Shrika and Ayur is getting. Swadhi, very good, very good. So most of the people are getting. Yes. Now you have to tell why the warning is coming. Why the warning is given to me? What is the warning? Kindly, whether you are getting this warning?
Yes, because gender, two groups.
So that is not a logic. That is why it's come like this. So management, three classification, government, aid, and self-finance. The N is there. The first table and second table is talking about descriptive. What is the third table? What is the third table? What is the third table?
Livens test.
Livens test.
Livens test. What is testing? What is the Livens test?
Homogeneity.
Homogeneity. Now you can see what is the homogeneity. What is the p-value? 0.24. Mm-hmm. Is it significant or not significant? 0.05 level.
Not significant.
Not significant means what? Not significant means what?
Null hypothesis is rejected.
Not rejected. It means
not rejected.
Not rejected.
Not rejected.
Not rejected.
Homogeneous.
What is it? Can you tell?
It's homogeneous.
Exactly. That is the word is important. Instead of null hypothesis accept reject, it's not correct. You can tell not significant means both the groups' variance are same. That is called homogeneity. It satisfies the homogeneity. Therefore, we can see the down table. Suppose it's not in the homogeneity, no need to look on this table. You got clear? Because it's not fair. If you are showing that it's not homogeneity, then what is the need to show, go with ANCOVA? You got clear?
Yes.
Now,
yes.
I already mentioned there's a two main effect. One, interaction effect. See this case. You can remove the corrected model and intercept is not needed. You can directly go with management. The management type, you can see the degrees of freedom, mean square. Why the management's degrees of freedom too? Anyone having the idea?
Three groups are there. So three categories are there. So
three DF. Yeah. Yes. What is the gender? Why is the gender is coming? One.
Male and female are there. Two minus one.
Yeah. So in this case, management and the interaction effect formula is R minus one, C minus one. Okay. What does that mean in the sense? The management degrees of freedom, gender degrees
two
of freedom.
One.
Therefore, it comes true, right? You are getting no? Right. Now see the F value. What is the F value of management? What is the F value of management?
49.78.
What is the P value?
0.00.
Please, what is the interpretation? Is it significant or non-significant?
Significant.
It means what? The main effect. What is the main effect if significant? Management. There is a significant effect on significant effect of management on in the steady habits. You got clear? So there is a significant difference of government school, aided school, and self-finance school students in their steady habits. Therefore, one hypothesis tested. You don't have doubt, no? The one hypothesis tested, the main effect of the management is to be significant. Then parallel you can see the effect size. There is a partial eta square. That's called effect size. What is the value you are getting? What is the score you are getting? 0.09. multiply with 100. You can multiply with 100. What is the answer you are getting?
9.1.
It means that 9.1% of variances may happen to the dependent variable because of the independent variable effect. You got clear? 9.1% of effect it happened from the management side. Now I'm going to the gender. See the gender. What is the F value? 0.722. What is the P value?
0.396.
What it means?
Not significant.
Therefore, what it means? There is no significant difference between male and female students in the study habits. You got clear? Therefore, the second main effects checked. What is the percentage of influence?
0.1%.
That is only one.
Only 1%. So not one. 0.1%. If you multiply by 100, right? Now I'm going the third hypothesis. What is my third hypothesis?
Management interaction effect.
So the management and gender. See this case. What is the P value? 25. What is the significant value?
0.000.
It is significant. The interaction effect of management and gender making influence on the study habits. Then what is the percentage of influence?
4.8.
You got clear? Now, how we can ensure it's significant? You can see the table, you can see the down. There is a graph. You are getting the graph?
Yes.
You are getting the graph, two graphs. One graph, there is no interaction. How we can check the interaction may happen in the sense? There's a two lines you are getting. There's a two lines, blue color line and green color line. If the lines are intersect with each other, that's called interaction happen. You got clear? If the lines are, the two lines are intersecting each other, then we can come for conclusion that there is an interaction happen between the two independent variable and to the dependent variable. You got clear? So even we can do the interpretation, we can write the interpretation based on the diagram also. See here, this for the diagram I'm showing the diagram representation. This is for the repeated meshes ANOVA, two-way ANOVA. Yes, see this diagram. If the diagram comes like in the first column, the first row you are getting, that is called no interaction. There is no interaction in the first row. But in the second diagram, the second row diagram, you are getting the interaction. Even this one is interaction number, but some kind of relation is there, like it's going like a V shape. Therefore, some kind of interaction, little interaction happens. Interaction is statistically significant if you're getting this kind of diagram. So, kindly see from the diagram itself, we can see whether the interaction happened or not. Yes, I'm moving to the. If you want to see the other one, like if you see the down, you are getting the mean slope. That is not needed. That's why I'm skipping. Okay. Yes. Do you have any doubt in this? Can we go to three-way ANOVA? Okay. Just I'm going fastly. You can do the interpretation invariant. Univariate. I'm going with three-way ANOVA. What we can do? Qualification. Okay. Please, I request all to mute. There's a sound is coming. Within 5 minutes, I think it's okay, please. Because I'm not... Otherwise, can you join any 2:30? If you join 2:30 before half an hour, before 2:30, I can give some demonstration. The remaining things also, because we already.
So now only we can continue now, sir.
It's not an issue because you want no, to take.
Not, not for us. We can finish it off, sir. It goes. It's going in a kind of.
Okay. Okay. Then it's okay. Then it's good. Okay. So it takes only 15 minutes. Okay, maximum. Please kindly bear with me because if I go very fast, you cannot follow. That's why I'm going a little slow. See, I'm adding the three variable as independent. I already make it plot. So in the plot, the three is there. That's why I'm going with horizontal, gender, then one is qualification. Okay, I'm going with the three also. Yeah, so it's not working because the three, we cannot go for interaction because three lines, we cannot come for any kind of interaction because if you go with the three independent variable, two pair is there, then three pairs may be there. That is why we cannot do for the interaction effect with the diagram representation. Therefore, I'm skipping this one. Go with the post-rock. I'm going with only the management only, selecting the key. Then go with the options. If you need the the mean schools, you can go with this one. Then select the three things, discrete statistics, estimate, and homogeneity. Then click continue. We can, okay, then click OK. Click OK. So those who need want to go, take a food, you can leave the meeting and then go. Okay, please don't be suffer because of my classes. You can go and take a food. If you want to leave the meeting, not at all issue, you can leave the meeting. Yeah, so now see this diagram. So I'm coming to the report. So we are getting the report. Very big report you are getting. The management gender qualification. Whether it's a 3-way ANOVA or 2-way ANOVA? 3-way ANOVA, 2-way ANOVA. Can you tell in the chat box?
3-way.
It is 3-way ANOVA. Yes.
3 variables.
Yes, please. Now the Levenge test, see here. The Levenge test is showing that equal variance.
There is significant
homogeneity. Therefore, no need to be look on this one. Anyway, it's not needed. Just so you can see the interpretation. It's not needed to look on it, but you can see whether how the interpretation is coming. Gender, significant RS or not? Gender?
No, sir.
No.
No. Not
qualification?
Yes.
Qualification?
Yes.
Then management and gender?
Yes.
Significant.
Management qualification?
No. Significant.
Gender qualification?
Not significant.
No.
The three, management, gender, and qualification?
Not significant.
No. Not significant.
That's good. Okay, that's good. Just I'm moving to the other exam because we cannot be see the down thing if you don't have the homogeneity. I'm going with the other variable instead of yesterday. I'm going with the achievement now. I'm removing the achievement. So I'm removing the problem. Yeah, I'm keeping the sample. Yeah. I'm going with the 2-way ANOVA only. Then only the results may come. That's what I'm clicking. And click OK. Yeah, I'm keeping the first homogeneity. I'm checking the homogeneity. See the homogeneity. This also not satisfying. This also not satisfying.
Yeah.
Okay. So it means that our data, you are not correct. What is it? You are not keeping the data properly. So there is a problem with our data collection. Yeah, this also is an issue. See here. Okay. So I will change the independent variable. I can change the independent variable. So I can change the independent variable. Instead of a gender, I put as here locality. We will see what happens. That's also not fitting. So we have to crack check whether it's new app for the this
if kind of please,
I request all to mute. I request you all to mute. There is a lot of excellent sound. Yeah. Now I'm going with this one, this comparison. See here, there is a comparison. Management and residence. Management took three classification, residence and two classification. Therefore, I'm using the intelligence. I'm using the intelligence. The homogeneity is satisfying. Homogeneity is satisfying. Now you have to write the interpretations. Main effect management is to be significant. Residence not significant. Management residence, it is significant. Therefore, interaction effect is there. So how we can ensure the interaction effect? If you see the diagram, sorry, I'm not selecting the diagram. One second, I'm selecting the diagram. Go with the plot. Management residence, one plot, then residence and management, second plot. Yeah, click OK and then run. So apparently you can go with the option also. Yeah, it's option I fixed. Yes, I'm clicking OK. So in the Levenge test, it's showing the homogeneity. Therefore, I'm seeing the down table. In the down table, see here, management significant, residence not significant, management and resident is significant. Therefore, damn sure our diagram, what it happened, there is a interactions may be there. See, you are getting no, there is an interaction. So this is called ANOVA. I moved to the ANCOVA very fastly. I'm going to general linear model, univariate. I'm keeping the steady habits as an independent variable. Covariate is intelligence. What is the hypothesis anyone can tell? Is it a one-way ANOVA or a one-way, I'm going with only one variable. See. What is this? Anyone?
One-way
ANCOVA. Yeah, so what is the assumption? Dependent variable one, independent variable 1, 3 classification. Covariate should be 1, but it is continuous. Okay. I'm going to do a ANCOVA. What is the hypothesis? Anyone can tell the hypothesis? What is the hypothesis? Normally, in the case of the experimental method, we are using the ANCOVA. Please, only 1 minute. When we're doing the ANCOVA, it's better for the experimental method. Because the experimental, we want to control pretest scores and all, influence and all. So here I make the hypothesis like this. There is no significant difference in the adjusted posterior mean scores of experimental group and control group by taking the pretest as a covariate. This is for the experimental method. Here I'm doing a survey. Therefore, what is the hypothesis in the sense? There is no significant difference in the mean scores of study habits with respect to management after keeping the covariate, after nullifying the effect of the intelligence. Like that, you can make the hypothesis that keeping the consideration intelligence a covariate. So what did happen? I'm going to check whether management is influencing the study habit after controlling the intelligent effect. So this is the hypothesis testing. I'm going to plot. Because here the three variables, no need for going with, because no need to do the interaction also, because here only one independent variable, therefore no need to go for the interaction effect. Then I'm going with the options. In the options, I'm selecting the estimate and homogeneity. Then I'm going with okay. So in this ANCOVA test, the postcard won't be enabled. See here, if I remove the, you are enabled the postcard test. But when you're doing the ANCOVA, the post-hoc test won't be enabled. So you cannot do the ANCOVA, post-hoc test in the case of ANCOVA. I'm clicking OK. So if you go with ANCOVA, click it OK, see this case. This for the descriptive. What is the Levenger test telling?
Not significant.
Not significant. Therefore, yeah. Homogeneity is satisfied. Therefore, we can see the down table. So we can accept the down table. We can keep it the table. Then now see here, the intelligence is my, what is my variable? Covariate, confounding variable. Okay. In the confounding variable. So in the confounding variable, the FL is 33.0. So normally the intelligence are affecting, the intelligence affect much on the dependent variable. Okay. How much percentage is influencing?
3.2%.
But here we are doing the some kind of adjusted mean scores because we are doing ANCOVA. We are checking the adjusted mean scores of management after nullifying the effect of the intelligence. We are checking whether the management influencing, whether only the independent variable having the influence on the dependent variable after controlling the effect of the third variable of intelligence. Now see the management. What is the F value? 22. What is the P value?
0.00.
So it means that after the nullifying the effect of the variable of the intelligence, we are checking, we are getting the significant also. It's a good result. Then how much percentage is influencing?
4.3.
So now you get it. You got it. So this is called
interpretation, sir. How to write interpretation?
Yeah, you can write the interpretation. I will show the experimental method because I'm having that result only. See these results, the same only. So here you can write the result like this. Then it shows that there is a statistically significant differences in the, and I'm talking about that, there is a significant differences in the management between the groups. Management on what is the variable study habits when adjusted the intelligence score. Otherwise, we can treat it as a intelligence as a covariate. So it means that we are nullifying the effect of the intelligence. Then we can check whether only the independent variable may influence on the dependent variable after controlling the effect of the dependent variable. You have to write like this. How we can write the interpretation in the sense based on this table here. So I'm showing the table. Yeah, the table showing that the management after nullifying the effect of the significant value 0.00, highlighting that there is a significant difference between the government aided and self-financed schools students in their study habits after controlling the effect of intelligence. You got clear? You got clear?
Yes, sir.
And just I'm moving very fastly with the experimental method also, because the particularly for doing the experimental method, you had to do the uncover. I'm going opening the experimental method data. So I'm opening the Excel sheets. In the Excel sheets, I'm opening the Excel. I'm opening the experimental method. Okay. So now the experimental data is coming. So in this case, pretest is my covariate. You got clear? Pretest is my covariate. Post is my dependent variable. What is my independent variable? What is my independent variable?
A group.
Group. It's so
currently group or control group?
Control group, exactly. So this way you have to write the hypothesis like this. There is no significant difference in the adjusted postal to means of experimental group and control group by taking pretest as a covariate, right? Just I'm going with this analyze general linear model univariate, right? I'm going with which test I have to keep it dependent? Can you tell firstly?
Dependent is post.
What is my covariate? What is the fixed factor?
Group.
Okay, good. So what are things we have to do? Options. Group. Descriptive. Estimates.
Homogeneity.
Click continue. Then other things not needed. Click OK.
Okay.
Now see the
homogeneity.
Yeah. Livenji, what is that highlighting?
It is not significant.
There is homogeneity.
Okay, therefore, it's a homogeneity. Therefore, we can see the down table. The pretest influences, whether the pretest influence or not. It's not significant.
How much influence is influencing?
1.1%. Therefore, it's not much influence. Even the 1.1% of influence also, we are nullifying with the use of uncover. After nullifying the effect of the effect, we are checking whether our treatment is to be effect or not by using the group techniques. I'm checking whether the control group, experimental group having a significant difference after controlling the extra influence. What did happen?
Significant.
How many percentage?
8.1. 81.7%.
It means that your treatment is making much influence on your dependent variable.
Yes, okay.
81.1% of influence because it happened because of your treatment, not because of the other external variable. You got clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, thank you so much. I'm skipping some other things. One is called, I'm not talking about the two-way. Because suppose if I keep it this one, what will happen? This called?
Two-way encore.
Two-way encore. Just I'm keeping, see here, I'm keeping the results. This also satisfying the 11G. So what did happen? What is the hypothesis here? I'm checking with the group and gender, right? And
two independent variables.
Covariate is a pretest. So in the pretest, significant is not there, but group is significant, gender not significant. Interaction also?
Not significant.
So your background variable is not making much influence on the interaction also. So that is a great output. So nice output. Okay. Right. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me now. So now it's 1:30.